Okay, we are live now. So great. Welcome to Tamarah's Closet today. I have a very fun musician with me today. And I say that because of the way that I discovered him. About a year ago, there was a live video rolling around on Facebook of the most amazing jazz marching band in the streets of Vicchio, Italy. And I, at that time, I couldn't find out who they were. And incidentally, I interviewed the Italian pianist that had made the interview, that had made the video. But all of a sudden, that video started rolling around again a few weeks ago, and it's had over 4 million views. And I zoomed in, and I caught the name on the back of the one of the t-shirts. And so needless to say, I contacted them right away. And so that today I have with me the founder of that band. He is an amazing saxophonista, I hope I said that right, who has performed with many, many great artists over the past 20 years, including Natalie Cole and Kenny Wheeler and more. So many fabulous musicians. He's formed the most incredible jazz, Umbria jazz marching band, fusing together jazz, funk, and a little Latin music. And their energy is just incredibly contagious. Every time I listen to their videos, I really get in a good mood. And so I've had a lot of fun listening to their videos. And so it's just been really exciting for me to connect with him. Now, he is from Italy, so we're going to bear with us that we understand each other. But he has an incredible connection with the audience, the band, whether it's in the streets or on stage. So today, I want to welcome with me Dario Cecchini, who is founder of the Umbria Jazz Marching Band called Funk Off. Dario, are you still with me?
Yes, I am. Hello, Tamarah. Hello to everybody.
Well, it's so good, Dario, to have you here, and I'm really excited that I really have enjoyed listening to you. So I'm going to jump right into the questions because I know it's later where you are. I wanted to, if you could just tell me a little bit about your history with music as a child growing up, and were your parents involved?
Yeah. Well, I grew up in a family where jazz music was the music in my house because my father and my uncle really loved jazz music. So I grew up listening to jazz music, especially Dexter Gordon, Jerry Mulligan, Clifford Brown, this kind of bebop, mainly bebop. And so I grew up with that kind of music. In fact, I was like a very strange kind of teenagers, because when I was a teenager, for instance, Police were at the top, but I was listening to Dexter Gordon, for instance. So my family, yes, supported me when I decided to study music. And in my family, both my father and my uncle played the drums. My father also plays the piano, and he also plays the trombone now. I started playing the drums. Then I switched to the saxophone when I was 14, but I decided to be a saxophone, to try to be a saxophone player when I was more than 21 years old.
Wow. You know, I spelled saxophone so many different ways. I don't know if you saw that.
How do you say saxophone?
Saxophonista for you.
Saxophonista, yeah.
Yeah.
Saxophone player is saxophonista in Italian, yeah.
Yeah,
I like to write saxophone with the X. You know, in Italy, we don't have the X as a letter, but the saxophone, the name of saxophone is because the one who invented the saxophone was Adolf Sax, S-A-X. So I like to say saxophone with the X.
Awesome. Well, I know I wanted to, before we get into other questions, I just wanted to jump ahead because I didn't want to forget to ask you this. Because you played with some really, really great artists. And I mentioned in the ads, Natalie Cole and Kenny Wheeler, just for a couple. And I just wondered what it was like to, you know, perform with these great people. And do you have some favorites that...
Yeah, well, with Natalie Cole, in 2000, she made an European tour. She had her own musicians, American musicians, but in every country of Europe, they need three saxophones, two trumpets, and two trombones. And they get a local musician. So I was asked to play with Natalie Cole, and we made the Italian tour. It was really great. She was a very nice person, and it was great playing that music. We had a conductor, a feminine conductor, a lady. She was and she was beautiful. She was really perfect. We didn't make mistakes just because she was very good at conducting us. And then con Kenny Wheeler, I played more, in more occasion, because in small groups, so it was very exciting to collaborate with Kenny Wheeler, and he was a very, very nice person, very simple. You know, maybe Natalie Cole was a superstar. Kenny Wheeler was a great musician. You know, the level is different.
Yeah.
But they both, I had very beautiful experiences, both.
Oh, that's wonderful. I just wanted to mention that, and because I knew that had to be a great experience. Now, I wanted to go back, because you're the founder of the band, and you began forming Funk Off 18 years ago. How did all you guys meet? How did you form this large band?
Yeah, we met since we were very young, because the all of us at the beginning, when we started, we were from this small town you mentioned before, Vicchio, close to Florence. Yeah, Vicchio. We grew up together in the wind band of the town. We have a very, very old wind band, more than 200 years old. So I teach the music to some of them. I taught the music to some of them, because they are 8 years, 10 years younger than me. And so we know each other since we were very, very young, since we were boys.
Yeah. Did you, when you got together, did you originally intend to be a marching band, or did that come later?
Yes, definitely. No. My idea was to create a marching band. In those years, in the 90s, I was conducting a big band in Florence, in a school of Florence called CAM. And in that big band, I started working on my music, on the music I had in my head. That music was not really jazz, but neither funk music or soul music. It was a mix of all my testes. As I told you, I grew up in a family where jazz music was the music in the house. But I was born in the 63, so I grew up in the 70s, listening also to, I remember the first time I heard Stevie Wonder. Or the first time I heard Earth, Wind & Fire. Or when we went to the disco dancing, I don't know, KC and the Sunshine Band, or Kool & the Gang. So I grew up with all these kind of influences, you know.
Yeah.
So in that big band in the early 90s, I started writing music, I started arranging music, I started mixing all these kind of music alike. So I become more and more confident in the music I could write. You understand me?
Yes, I do.
And during one rehearsal of this big band, in this big band, I asked to play four or six guys that are now in Funkov. And in that big band, during a rehearsal, I had a vision. I said, wow, I could put up a kind of marching band where musicians dance, move to the rhythm of the music more than dancing, maybe move to the rhythm of the music, but with the sound of a street band, with the sound of a marching band, a small marching band. So I had this idea. Maybe also because in that period I was playing in very good bands, very good, with very good musicians, but I thought that in my way, in my ideal of music, musicians had to be more involved in the music. And I thought that the fact that they had to move to the rhythm could help the music to be more more filled by themselves and by the audience. That was my idea.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So how would you explain to the viewers who Funkoff is? Because I like that. Because it says Funkoff made in Vicchio.
Vicchio.
I know. I keep saying that wrong. Vicchio.
No, I know. Because in Italy, you know, C-H is K. It's like a K. Yeah. C-H is like a K. You know, my name, Cecchini.
Cecchini. Uh-huh.
In fact, everywhere in English speaking countries, they call me Cecchini.
Cecchini.
So you asked me.
How would you describe? Yeah, Funkoff made in Vicchio.
Funk made in Vicchio because our music is very often written in Vicchio. We rehearse it in Vicchio. We are from Vicchio. Vicchio is a beautiful town close to Florence. So our music is a kind of funk music, but not just funk music. It's funk made in Vicchio because we are from Vicchio. Funk made in Vicchio is a way of play the music.
Right.
Play involved with a lot of energy, with a lot of passion, with a lot of emotions, with a lot of movements. And Funkoff is a small band. It is like the sound could be similar to a big band, you know, as even though we don't have the trombones.
Right.
But the sound is similar to a marching band, in my opinion.
Yeah, well, I think you sound better than, I mean, you, but you know what? You started a trend, I read, and then, you know, there are other bands have come together since you got started, but you still stand out. What do you think makes you stand out from all the other bands, the marching bands?
Well, I think mainly... is the music, mainly, and the fact that maybe we were the first one who did the music in this way, so we gain a lot of knowledge on how to do it. I think we are very sincere, you know.
Yeah,
we play the music, my music, in a very sincere way, and people love it, and people feel it. you know? I think that's the music. I think in this kind of bands, in musical bands, the music is still the core of everything. You can look very nice, you can dance very nice, but if you play a bad music, that's it. There's nothing to do. We are not a boy band, you know? We are not a boy band.
Yeah, exactly. Well, let me, because after 18 years, you have, you've managed to stay together for a long time. And, you know, and I was just wondering, how do you, what's the secret to keeping the band together and keeping it motivated like that with inspiration?
Yeah, I don't know. I think that to stay together for a so long time, in our case, is particular case, because now we are really very close friends. We were friends also at the beginning, but now after 18 years, obviously, we spend a lot of time together during these years. So we are more friends than we are really close friends. And in some way, this could be also not a good thing for the leader, because sometimes if the leader is, we are all the same, we are all the same level, how can I explain it? But I try all the time to think for all the band. I don't think for myself, I think for 15 people. I try to do my best to make them happy the more I can. And maybe, and definitely to keep this band together, 15 person together. Sometimes you have also to learn and to how to say, I'm sorry, or I made a mistake, I was wrong, I'm sorry. Very, it happened, and unfortunately, I'm sure that it will happen again, that we have argued, we have problems, because it happens, it's normal everywhere.
Oh, yeah.
So it's important to say, okay, don't worry, I made a mistake. No, I made a mistake. Both of us, okay, well, we love each other. Okay.
Yeah, well, that's great. Well, you're equal. You treat each other equal.
But, yeah.
And you're doing great with your English. I really do understand you.
Oh, thank you very much. That's a very good compliment.
You know? You're doing good. I hope you can understand. I hope you can understand me.
Yes, very well. I think. I don't know if you ask me something else. Maybe I didn't understand you. But
if you ask me this. Well, how often do you guys have to get together since you've been together so long to practice like the dance moves as well as the music?
Yes, we meet. We get together once a week, now on Monday or on Wednesday, Tuesday, generally on Monday. We have a rehearsal for, we are supposed to have a rehearsal from 9:30 to midnight. But you know, we are Italian, so the time is not really so defined. So we should start around 9:30, but then we start playing around 9:45, 10 to 10, and we go until midnight. And the way we learn music and the way we put movements on the music, I bring the parts for the instrument of a new song. I don't know. We play. We start playing. We have to make the music work. We have to get the good groove, the good pronunciation of music. Everyone has to know what he plays, but also what the musician play around him. And then after this, we say, okay, next rehearsal, we have to try to play it by heart. At that point, when we play it by heart and everything is okay, we try to put the movements on it. So we maybe we thought about it at home, and I suggest this, why don't we do that? And that's the way we work on the music and on the steps.
Yeah, because you write the music yourself. You've written all of your music, right?
Yes. I've been doing this for 18 years. Before you ask me about inspiration, and it's difficult to find. I don't know. I think the inspiration is the most important thing for musicians, for artists in general. What I try to do is I try to write music different. And I'm glad that if you listen the first music of Van Gogh and you listen to the music we are playing now, you can listen that is different. I mean, I can hear that it's different.
Right.
The arrangements, the melodies, the structure of the song, the soloist, the band improved in the year so we can play better and things are more difficult. But I'm really worried about the inspiration. For instance, yesterday I wrote a new song and I'm trying to figure out if it is okay or if it is not. That's the problem for a musician. That's it.
Well, sometimes you just have to just play it for some people, and because you know you might be too critical of yourself. It's probably
no. You don't have to be too much critical, but
yeah,
I think it's necessary to be critical because. Not everything is okay. Not all the music. I mean, not all the music that I write can be okay.
Right.
Something is good. Something no. Like everything. Like you try to. When we do something, I think we are trying to do it at the best, but it's not. We are not able to do it all the time, right?
Yeah. Right. Oh, yeah.
Same is the music. When I write music, I think when every musician writes music or every painter paints something or a poet who writes a poetry, maybe sometimes it's okay. Sometimes you have to put in to leave it in your computer and that's it, just for you.
I know what you mean because I write, and sometimes some of the things I write I don't share because it's not something I would share, but it might just be something I keep to myself. But I know what you mean. You have good things and things that you don't want to share. But just Funk Off as a band, do you guys have a favorite street or place of performance that you like?
Well, there are 15 of us, so maybe every one of us has memories on a different place. But for instance, we have been playing in Perugia for Umbria Jazz for 13 years, and I can say that my favorite place maybe is Perugia or Orvieto, where we feel like we are at home, I have also very nice memories, for instance, of playing in South Africa. We did street parades in South Africa. Everything was everyone was so excited around us. I remember it, or I remember the first time we went abroad. We went to Patrasso in Greece. And I remember the people, it was maybe 1999, 1920, I don't remember, not 2000, 1999, 2000, those years. I remember the faces of that people who saw us for the first time. Or another place that I remember, another place that was really crazy, beautiful place for our street parade was in São Paulo, in Brazil. People,
oh, yeah.
Believe me, people went crazy. They saw us in São Paulo, they went crazy. We didn't expect it. We didn't expect it. An audience so excited. Yeah. Memories, my favorite memories, you know.
Was that when the Brazil, was that part of the BMW Jazz Festival, or was that a different time that you're
yeah. talking about? No. The BMW Festival. We were there in BMW. 2011, I think. We had a great time, even if we spend just 3 days in São Paulo. 3 days. In fact, I wrote a song entitled Three Days in São Paulo, Tres Dias in São Paulo. And I love really the way Brazilian live, you know? They are very relaxed, very nice with people. I love São Paulo very, very much.
Yeah. Well, what makes one street better to perform in than the other? Is it mainly just the people and their reaction, or is it something more?
Well, people and reaction of people is very important for us because it's normal. If you have a feedback by the audience, the more is the feedback, the more you are you find the energy and the concentration to go out to make a good job. Sometimes I can say that also the sound of some streets can help us to sound better. But yeah, mainly I have to say the people. The people is the reaction of the people gives us more energy and more. We make us more willing to play for them.
I wanted to quote you here. I read somewhere that said, you said in Italy, squares are more important than streets. Can you explain that? Because I've never been to Italy, and for any of the viewers who may have never been there, there's a difference. So what
yeah, the difference is because, yes, I'm sure I said it because, streets, you walk on the streets, but in the square, you stop by, you meet people. In Italy, if you go now in the square, in Vicchio, we have two squares, one very close to the other. I'm sure that you go there, you can find people talking close to the Monumento of Giotto, or at the bar drinking something, close to the car while they are waiting for maybe, I don't know, for the daughters or the son having somewhere, or in the other square you can find the mother with kids playing in the garden. Yeah, square are more important, and also Van Gogh maintained this kind of relationship with squares. For instance, if we are marching on streets, and if we find a square or a small square, we have a stop there. Mm-hmm. We put us in a circle and we play a small concert. Then we start again, we go forward, and if we find another square, we have another stop. That's the difference between square and streets.
Okay.
I think it's like this more or less everywhere, right?
Yeah. Well, I've got to go to Italy every time I look
at
your video.
You have to come. I'll show you the square in Vicchio. And you see people talking. Oh, where are you from? From America. Oh, beautiful, beautiful place.
Yeah, it looks so much fun just watching your videos and the energy of the people. But I read you're still the official Umbria Jazz Festival marching band, and you have been since 2003. How did they discover you?
They discovered us for because not all the time, but sometimes or very often, a manager can do a great job. In this situation, our manager did a great job because he was the manager of several groups. He saw us. At that time, we had a manager from Milan, Fabio Stucchi. And at that time, he saw us and he was very impressed by Funkov. But he was asked by Umbria Jazz to bring a group of his to Perugia. And he said, okay, I'll give you this band, but I want you also to book Funkov, this new band from Tuscany, Funkov. So you get the important one, but you have to get also these guys. And they said, okay, please send us these guys. And so it started. We went to Giardini Carducci, where there is a stage, not big stage, but big enough for us. And we played there for 3 days. And the second day we were asked to play before to open the concert of James Brown.
So wow.
It was like a dream come true.
And, wow.
And so it started. Then Umbria Jazz asked us to go to Orvieto during the winter for Umbria Jazz winter. And then we went back to summer. And now we have this kind of relationship very close with Umbria Jazz. We went with them to United States, to Australia, to Melbourne, to South Africa, to China. Umbria Jazz is the most important Italian festival, one of the most famous in the world, in Europe. So it is a big honor to be there, much better.
Yeah, I knew that, and I posted that on Facebook, so I wanted to make sure the viewers understood you, that is the most important jazz festival in the world. And I just thought that was so incredible that you have been with them for that long. I think that's really great, and you've gotten to go so many great places, too.
Yeah.
But you were also, we sort of touched on this, in 2011, you were the only Italian artist invited to the BMW Jazz Festival in Brazil. How did they find out about you?
They found about us. I think I remember that the director of the festival saw us in Orvieto during Umbria Jazz. And he liked the band, and he contacted our manager, and they invited us. We were in this incredible festival. We were the only Italian artist invited. And I remember that in that year, there was Marcus Miller and Joshua Redman and Wayne Shorter. And we were in the same hotel with them. So yeah, we had a good time.
Wow, I just think that's so good. But you've had so many great opportunities. Now, I know you performed in New York, and I was wondering what you thought about New York, and would you like to go back to New York?
Well, definitely we would like to go back. I love New York City. I've been there 5 times. One of my best friends is a New Yorker. He's from Brooklyn. I met him in Italy, but he's a New Yorker. And I really love New York. Playing, when we played in New York, it was in the 2004, we played at the International Association for Jazz Education. We went to New York with Umbria Jazz, and then we played in a club close, I think, on the 56th Street. I can't remember now. And the bar, the club was the O Bar. I remember the name. And we had a good, it was incredible because the band was, it was only 6 years old, and we were playing a kind of, how can I say, jazz music in New York City. it was unbelievable. Yes, we had a great time. It was, a winter, the winter with a lot of snow. It was 20 degrees under zero in New York, but we had a beautiful, beautiful time over there. And we hope to go back. Who knows? Maybe in the future.
Maybe, I know. Well, when you...
It's very difficult for North American artists to play in the United States. It's complicated.
You tell me that, and I hate that. Somehow we gotta fix that. But when you tour and perform at all these different places, are you mostly on stage, or are you in the streets, or a mix of both, or?
Well, now I have to be sincere. When I started Funk Off, I was thinking about a marching band. Well, the first time we were asked to play on stage, I was not very sure that things could work. You know what I mean? My idea was of a marching band, not a band to stay on stage. But we were asked to play on stage, and during the year we developed this kind of show. It's different than when we have to parade on the streets. And now, very often we are asked to play both on stage and on streets. For instance, in China, where we played recently, we mainly played on stage, big stage, huge stage, with a lot of people, with thousands of people in front of us, and everything was very, very nice. So now I think both. For instance, I make you another example. We were this year in April 29th, we are going to Basel in Switzerland to play with Funk Off on stage. This will be the third time we are in at Basel Jazz Festival. The first two we played a street parade. This year they asked us to have a concert on stage. So now both of the show.
Right. So, but you know, when I watch the videos of you on stage, you guys, the people love you on stage as well. You've had some big crowds and you seem to have developed, you've gotten comfortable doing that for sure,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah. Yeah. Because, because we have been doing this for now 17 years. So, for instance, we recorded 6 CDs now, right? And so this means that probably 70, 75 songs written for Funk Off, right?
Yeah.
Now we can play, I think, around 40 songs, okay? We can play by heart at the moment 40 songs. Of these 40 songs, there are maybe 20 that can be played mainly on the street, 20 that can be played mainly on stage, and an amount of this who can play it both in the show. So I think that the show on stage is different because it's more balanced, has to be more balanced respect the show, respect to the street parades. But I like both.
You like both?
Yeah, definitely.
You like doing both. Okay, I was wondering if you like one better than the other, but you sounds like you like both.
Well, maybe to be sincere, yes. I have a small preference for the show on stage.
Because, oh, you do? Okay.
Yes, because music has to be more balanced. We are more concentrated on music, so music often is better on stage. But we are a marching band, so we are a marching band. And we don't need to be too much precise, you know? We don't need to be too much disciplined to play in funk off. We have to have good time. Maybe sometimes on the street we have too much good time. We have too much fun, but it's okay. It's a funk off style.
I read that. I read where sometimes you just start laughing and but I would think that that's a nice balance of having that opportunity to be a little more yourselves and engage with people in a different way than when you have to, when you're on stage. So,
But if you see some show also on stage, we laugh also on stage because very sometimes happens some. Things happen that are funny, we have to laugh. But I like it. I think it's okay. It's not we have to play well. We have to play in the correct way. We have to be in tune. We have to be in time. We have to be sensitive. But if we have to laugh because there is something that we have to laugh about, it's okay. We'll play the good notes later.
Well, I think you guys are fun to watch, and I love all the photographs too. I really do. It's just you can tell you guys have a great sense of humor, and I've been fascinated just by all the videos, and so it gets me excited about wanting to go to Italy. But seems like, what is it about the energy and the people in the streets in your country? Because it's just different there than here. I mean, I guess it's just people are used to being in the streets more.
Well, unfortunately, I don't have the experience of street parades in the United States. I would like to compare the different audiences. But what I can say is that in Italy, many towns, many also small towns, as my town, as Vicchio, has a wind band. So people are used to see the wind band, to listen to the wind band, and to follow the wind band while we are marching. So that's the way. I think this is normal for us. There is a wind band. All right, let's go and listen to them. Okay, they march. Okay, let's go with them. Let's see what's going on. And we have a great tradition of wind band, especially in the south of Italy. They have very, very, very good marching band. Also in the center and in the north, but the south maybe more. And so we grew up with the band, what we call La Banda, you see.
La Banda.
La Banda, yeah. And I think this is, so the audience is used to follow the wind band.
Right.
It is like, very often if you see some picture of us in big town, you see like a river of people behind us, you know. They follow us, they clap their hands, they move their steps with us. It's very funny.
Yeah, I saw that. I mean, I just think it looks like so much fun. I do. It's just, I mean, we don't really see that around here like that. So I just think
you have to come.
So
come to Biagio this summer.
I know.
Yeah, Biagio is... this summer is July 7th to 17th. So 10 days, you can follow us for 10 days.
Wow.
At the very end, you'll be in a pretty good shape.
I know, and I have to bring my camera. Oh, God. What do you think? Because I talked to you about when we met the first time on Google. I asked you what you thought about that video that was going around, because it's getting close to 5 million views now.
Yeah.
And
see, really? 5 million. Wow.
People love that video, Dario. Yeah. And
I think I have to be sincere, because we were a kind of surprised, because this video, but it's good. I reflect about this fact, because this video shows Funkov like you are in the middle of Funkov, because the camera is in front of me. So it's very natural what I do. I ask to the organizers, to the owners, where we have to go. We street, okay, then I turn to the band, guys, now we have to go straight away, then we turn left, okay, we have to, let's play, I don't know, let's play Hippo Tripo, okay, ready, no, wait, I have to take my shirt off, okay, ready, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, pa. It is like this, you know,
yeah.
It's natural.
Yeah.
So maybe this thing impressed more viewers, or I'm sure that Francesco Tascaiali has a lot of friends all over the world, because 5 million of viewers is incredible. But
yeah.
We are very happy, and I have to thank Francesco for this, for the way he made Funkov known to a lot of people, and now that's why I'm here with you.
It is, I know. And, you know, that day
so
I saw
you,
that.
Francesco.
Yeah, thank you, Francesco. And, you know, he's a great guy. And, you know, and that video, I think, because it is just so natural, and he took it with his cell phone, and it was live, and it just got a lot of attention, and then it just skyrocketed, and it was just so much fun, and people are still sharing it. So I don't know. I just think it says a lot about who you guys are, but I think also it just shows a lot about Vicchio. It's the way things are there, and it's just for people who've never been there. And
well, that video was taken in Latina. Latina is a town in the center of Italy. Is not taken in Vicchio, but it shows,
oh, okay.
Yes, yeah, it shows how funk made in Vicchio works.
Yeah. But you've been a part of like 30 CDs, 10 that were your own, and the 10 that were your projects, were these all part of Funkov?
Yeah. Funkov are definitely a part of the CD of mine, because maybe I'm more Funkov than other. I don't know,
yeah,
if you understand what I mean.
I do.
Funkov are a big part of me. I wrote more than 70 songs for Funkov, and I'm known. Yes, I'm known as Dario Cecchini, but Dario Cecchini is the leader of Funkov, so Funkov are maybe the most important part of me, musically.
Right. Yeah.
I love it. I mean, I have done other CDs as leader, where I wrote the music, where I write the music, when I choose the musician and stuff like that, but Funkov is I'm not famous, but if I would be famous, I would be famous for Funkov, not for the,
yeah,
rest of the
music. Well, you guys are great, and you're very loyal to each other. I wanted you to have a chance to talk about, you mentioned South Africa, because I watched that video, and I agree with you. The people there were they just loved you. And I've interviewed a lot of artists in South Africa, so I know that was part of the Umbria Jazz Tour. But you did some clinics there too. So
yeah,
what were these?
Yeah, South Africa was it was an incredible experience. Musical level and at human level, for us as human beings, because we went in that place that, now is the moment when we are talking about racism unfortunately, and the racism, the apartheid was legal over there, was normal over there until 25 years ago. So we are talking about, we could feel that things are changing over there, changed very fast in the recent year. And it was really a great experience for us. We played in the schools. We played also in a theater. We had a concert, but we played mainly in this town. Not really town with big houses, with small house, with I don't remember the name, but very poor, in a very poor places. But
in a very poor place.
Yeah, but people were very nice, smiling. They were completely, they loved our music. They danced with us. They spent time with us. They were curious about us. And we are talking about only black people. The song of people who were in the apartheid before, and that's so sad, but they look so happy. So it was very, very touching, very moving. That experience in South Africa, we were obviously Poncoff, but with us there were some persons of Umbria Jazz, some other musician who spent their time with us. When we went to do the clinics, some people from South Africa who was with us to drive us. It was an experience so deep that I think that that experience changed us a bit as human person, but also in the relationship between us. We are more friends now. We had that experience so deep, so particular, so touching, that things change after South Africa.
Yeah, I do want to go there. But what were the clinics that you were?
Clinics. In the clinics, we went to some schools, and we talk about our music, we talk about the way we put up songs, the way I use, for instance, the saxophone, the way we use the trumpet, how we make things work between bass line and drum section. We talk about it. It was the last lesson we had. It was in a music school, and there was a choir, and they sang for us. They were so happy, and they told us, "We want to thank you, and we will sing this song for you, a typical song." It was a moment, a very touching moment, a very touching situation.
Oh, I bet that was beautiful. The video, I really enjoyed the video. You could see how happy all the South Africans were with you there, and I thought that was very touching.
We hope that we'll go back. We are still working on it, but it's complicated, you know, it's very complicated.
Yeah, I know. Well, I hope you can go back. I do. Now, I know you mentioned also your dream place would be New Orleans, but you said it was just so difficult, you know.
Yes, it is difficult, but as I told you, it's complicated to come to United States to play. But for instance, I can tell you this fact, that there was an American manager who met us maybe 13 years ago in Perugia, and he told me, "I'll try to bring you to New Orleans. I'll try," and he said me this for 3 or 4 years. Then he stopped telling this. So I asked him, "Are you still trying to bring Fankov to New Orleans, and he told me, too much complicated. It is like bringing snow to Alaska. So it's complicated, you know. But yeah, it would be like a dream come true to play in New Orleans, because that's where this kind of movement of marching band, not play the march, European march, started. When this kind of groups started, I listened. When I was a teenager, an older friend of mine, a musician, Stefano Scalzi, a trombone player, a very close friend of mine, he suggested me the Dirty Dozen Brass Band, and I heard them, and they are from New Orleans too. So I would like to play in New Orleans, maybe on Mardi Gras, I don't know. What I can say is that in Orvieto, during Umbria Jazz, I met a musician. He stopped me and he told me, yeah, I saw your band, you're great. So I said, thank you, where are you from? And he said to me, he was from New Orleans. So I told him, oh, thank you very much. For me, your compliments value double, because you are from where the roots of this kind of music are. And he told me, and I will remember it for the rest of my life, he told me, yes, we are the roots, but you are the branches.
Oh, okay.
So for me, it was really a great compliment.
That is. Well, is there another dream place that you have besides New Orleans?
Well, we played in a lot of places, so New Orleans would be enough.
I know. Well, maybe it'll happen one day. You just never give up hope. But do you have a CD in the works now, or are you working on some new?
Yeah, we are working. The music is ready. We are already performing the music during street parades. The new music during street parades and during concert on stage. So I think there are 12 or 11 songs, I can't remember now. And so we are ready. We have just to find the days to record, maybe in April or maybe May, or we are going to record maybe in October or November, I don't know. I would like to record it now, because we are ready. We are ready to record it.
You've got a great website, so I'll make sure that everybody knows how to get it. I've got one more question though. What would you say you like most about what you do?
I can say that the music gives me a reason to live, and also music is the way to support myself, my family. I'm living with music. I'm also a teacher and music teacher. So, about Fankov, what I like most about Fankov is the fact that what was just a silly idea now is a project, now is a band that is still going on, and that has been going on for 18 years, and that also with Fankov I made not only good music, but I also made friends. Because Fankov are my friends, are my life, you know. So, yeah, I think I'm glad because I can live with music, for the music, and that's it.
Yeah, and Fankov is probably like family to you now, too.
Yes, it is. As I told you, they really grew up together, because the majority of them has the same age. we have three brothers in Fankov, one cousin. So, and they are same age. They are in five, 4 years. I'm a bit older, but it's not a problem.
Well, now are you?
Maybe it's better for the for the one in chair to be a bit older, no?
Yeah.
Don't you think?
Oh yeah, you're the father figure.
Yeah, not really the father, I've been the other.
I know you're not that old. Well, you
well, if you think that between me now, not when we started. When we started, the difference was 16 years between me and the youngest Pankov. Now the difference is the youngest Pankov is 30 years old. I'm 53, so it's 23 years. Unfortunately, I'm 23 years older.
Yeah.
So I could be also his father.
Oh, yeah. Now, you're teaching, do you teach every day or?
No. I teach at conservatory in Italy, okay. At Livorno, and also in another city. I can't say it, but I think I'm studying very soon. So, no, I teach twice a day, twice a week.
Okay.
Completely from the morning to the late afternoon, but it's okay at the conservatory, so good students, good schools, everything's okay.
I want to thank you again for joining me today, Dario. This has just been, I really have enjoyed spending time with you and getting to know more about your band. And you know, I just love the music. I don't know what it is about you guys, but I have the videos, and every time I play them on my laptop here, like in the mornings if I'm getting ready, it just puts me in a really good mood, a happy mood, something about your energy. So it's been a lot of fun for me.
Yes, I know. Yeah. I know that Pankov music is positive, it's a positive music. But what I want to say is that it happens. I mean, I'm not looking for writing good music, positive music, but it comes like this.
Right. Well, it's so much fun, and you guys are fun, so I've got to get to Italy, because I love your photographs. I want to photograph you guys. I know. I love that photograph. Is this one where you're all laying down, and that was really funny. I like that. That's cute. I do. But is there anything else you want to mention that we didn't? Do you have any announcements that you want to mention?
That we are going to play now in at the end of April. We are going to play in Basel at Basel Jazz Festival in Switzerland. Then we are going to Blue Note in Milan. So if somebody in Milan wants to come and see us, we'll be very happy. And then we are playing in Perugia for Umbria Jazz. All the old period. We are playing for Interni. Is another town in Umbria for in the Easter period. So we have a lot of concerts. We hope to see a lot of people. And I want to thank you because you invited me here, and you tried to understand my English. And so I have to thank you. I have to say that we are just back from. Me and two other Frankov, the drum section, we are just back from Norway, where we had a seminar to a band, the BMK band in Norway. So I know that they are watching this show, this interview, so I want to say hi to them in Norway.
Oh, good. Well, they'll be able to see our, it's recorded, so they'll be able to see the recording. And so that's great. And it's just been so much fun having you here. And all your tours will be on, they're in their website, right? Is that correct?
Yeah, website, on Facebook page, Funk
yeah.
Off.
Yeah, it's www.funkoff.it, and I'll have all that up below the YouTube video and in my blog too. I'll have the links to your social media sites, Dario. So I'll have all that on there so people know how to get in touch. And there'll also be a replay of this interview on Tamarah's Closet YouTube channel and in my blog at tamarahscloset.com. So I ask the viewers to please share this and help me continue to celebrate Funk Off and Dario Cecchini. They're just such a great group of musicians. And so I just want to thank the viewers. Stay tuned for more live interviews in Tamarah's Closet, and thank you for your continued support. And please share this replay so that I can continue to celebrate Dario Cecchini and Funk Off. And
thank you, Tamarah.
Yes,
Tamarah, you are invited to Italy. Eh? Remember,
I am. I'm coming. Don't you hang up. I'm gonna say bye to the viewers. Don't hang up. I'll say bye to you after. So to your own success, to the viewers, keep on rocking it, and we will see you soon.